More than a quarter of a million Australians live with epilepsy, with most cases being diagnosed at a young age or in people over the age of 65. Now, treatment can sometimes mean surgery, but these days there's the option of cannabis oil. However, there are some pretty big hurdles for families with that treatment. So here to share their stories, Jo Freeman and her six-year-old son, Cooper, as well as Carol Ireland from Epilepsy Action Australia. Welcome to the show.
Welcome.
Jo, can I just say, your little boy Cooper, he's so beautiful. He's six. Take us back to the diagnosis. When did you first know something was wrong with Cooper and that perhaps he needed to be looked at for epilepsy?
Yeah, sure. Cooper was born with a rare chromosome deletion, so from the get-go we knew we had some hiccups. But on just after Cooper's fourth birthday, he developed epilepsy. It took about 6 months to be confirmed with some EEG testing and the like.
So he would just suddenly have seizures? No, how did that manifest?
No, the first time I found him was after his day sleep, and I went in there just to check on him and I thought he was dead.
Oh my gosh. He was just
staring vacantly ahead with his eyes open, just stiff, and I just picked him up. I ran out the back. I'm yelling at the neighbour, please call an ambulance, I think he's dead. And so that was a really traumatic day, obviously, and things were okay for a month. We sort of put it down to maybe he had a cold, maybe I'd given him too much, Panadol or something to that and made him groggy. But I knew I hadn't, but you want to think that
you just
at the
knew
time.
Something was wrong.
Yeah, I think you try to look for an easier outcome than thinking, I've got epilepsy. You don't want that. So then we didn't have a second seizure for about a month. And then after that, they just progressively got faster and faster. Wow. And so the time in between was less and less.
How terrifying.
After sort of 6 months, we got confirmed that it was epilepsy. So we started on traditional medications. None of that seemed to work. Having a rare child, we do a lot of therapy. So, you know, the source of all your information is other mothers. They're the ones with all the knowledge. And so they were saying, you've got to get on cannabis oil. Cannabis oil is the way to go. So obviously I approached the neurologist and the paediatrician and they said, no, Coop didn't fit the criteria for a clinical trial. So I was, okay, well, that can't deter me. I've got to find another method. Mm. So I got a contact from a mum at therapy in Western Australia and that worked great for 6 months. Then I went to Hemp Expo, found a new friend, and...
Hemp Expo. It is sad when you have to actually, you know, rely on things like that which aren't totally legal to try and care for your own son.
So what is the status now of... because we hear a lot about medicinal marijuana and cannabis oil, and it's being increasingly sort of legitimised. I thought it was above board these days. But
the government do say that, and we are now in a fortunate position where we do buy it legally. We do get it from the chemist. But in saying that, I have to jump through a lot of hurdles each month. We still have to sign a waiver to say we're completely responsible for any of the outcome.
Right.
But we do it in the best possible way. Cooper has regular blood tests to ensure that there are no, adverse effects from this. But, the traditional medications, they have side effects.
Yeah.
For me, it's...
Carol, how accessible is medicinal cannabis for epilepsy sufferers?
Well, I mean, the regulations obviously changed a couple of years ago now, and so I think the general public do think that, cannabis is readily available, but you've only got to look at the reality of, the number of approvals for legal cannabis, and it's just over 2,000 in Australia, all conditions Australia-wide.
Wow.
The estimates are that up to 100,000, maybe even more, people are actually using cannabis on the illicit market.
Does it actually work? Does it help, though?
OK. My story is the greatest for it. Cooper went to preschool 2 years ago and only went 2 days but never made both days. He would be knocked out, never...
From the traditional medicine?
Yep. So he would have a seizure at 7 in the morning, be knocked out to around about 1 o'clock in the afternoon. Both of us, it impacted our days because we would be in bed, he's asleep and I'm watching him, and then he'd come to and be groggy, couldn't do therapy, couldn't do anything. So we went on a product from a company called Tilray, a medicinal cannabis oil company from Canada.
And is it just a couple of drops of oil?
Yep.
Okay.
Coop's peg fed 1.5 mils daily, morning and night. last year, Cooper started big school. And so we started on this product in November last year. And in February, I'm saying to the teachers, he'll have lots of seizures. Call me, I'll come and get him. We never miss one day of big school.
Wow.
Really? So in over a year, there hasn't been
If I can extrapolate...
Next month.
If I can extrapolate, on that, we work with dozens and dozens and dozens of families. Joe's story, Cooper's story, is not unusual. Mm. We come from a position of being a fairly conservative organisation. Mm. I tell you what, 4 years ago, 5 years ago, when I first heard, I don't use the marijuana word anymore, but when I first heard that medicinal marijuana was treating epilepsy, I was horrified. Yeah. And I had a team of nurses that were horrified. These days, I would be one of the strongest advocates in Australia, and that's because parents like this have shared their story.
I'm probably a bit the same as you, because I thought years ago, I said, this is just a way for bong smokers to get their free dope. But in fact, a friend of mine who's a quadriplegic says the best thing for him to stop seizures, because he gets constant involuntary seizures, is cannabis oil, but he can't get it either. And why is there that resistance, do you think? Is it because people just think, marijuana, no, it must be dodgy?
I think we're still dealing with stigma. I find it quite ironic because I find that not a lot of people understand epilepsy. And, Sarah, you're probably surprised that it wasn't a seizure as you would know it that Cooper had.
That's right.
There are over 40, 45 different kinds of seizures and syndromes. So it's a really complex condition and a stigmatised condition. Then you're talking about cannabis, which of course is a stigmatised, our product with, 70 years of prohibition? Mm. And that's not only in terms of recreational use, but also research.
I mean, at least the thing with cannabis and marijuana is that it's a natural product. And I mean, I myself and everyone in the audience and all sorts of people, we're all on some kind of medication, whether it's heart medication or seizure medication or whatever. Mm. I just can't understand why they make it so hard for people like your son and people like your friend to get hold of it and have to jump through so many hoops. It's crazy.
Joe, was there ever hesitation when it came to giving your little boy cannabis, even though it's cannabis oil?
No.
Okay.
I think the side effects attached to the other traditional medications are just as, this was no worse for me. I didn't believe... we were doing it in a controlled... We still are doing it in a controlled environment, meaning we get regular tests and the like. So, for me, not.
Yeah.
And I think, to be clear, it's also... There's no psychotropic effects, are there, with the stuff you're using?
From the particular product, the Tilray product that little Cooper's using, it's a CBD, cannabidiol product. And no, there are
so
no
you've
psychoactive...
Taken all that. Yeah, that's fine.
That's not to say that there aren't some useful things about THC. We simply don't know what we don't know yet, and the research is ongoing.
Muscle relaxant,
but
all that
kind of
stuff.
For the little guys, children that are using it at the moment, the CBD product, no psychoactive effect whatsoever.
Because I remember my friend, the doctor, said this will have no effect on your mind whatsoever, and he was really disappointed.
And so why would it be diverted? That's the other thing. There's this fear of diversion.
Yeah,
that's right. But I suppose the argument that people are just after a free high or whatever is
they
rubbish.
Won't get it.
Yeah, they won't get it. Yeah.
Well, thank you so much for coming in and sharing your story. It's just extraordinary, Carol, and also Joe and little Cooper, who is absolutely adorable and did so well. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Sarah.